Amazon FSx is a new storage service that provides fully managed third-party file systems. Now, you'll see this coming up on the SAA C02 exam, and I had a few questions on my exam when I did the beta. Some of the design patterns that you'll associate FSx with are high-performance computing, machine learning, and electronic design automation. There are two different types of file system that are available today. There's the FSx for Windows file server, and there's the FSx for Lustre for compute-intensive workloads. So let's have a quick look at each of these different types of FSx file system. So this is the FSx for Windows file server. And what you have is you can connect your Windows-based applications. So for instance, you might have EC2 instances running Windows, but you could also have on-premises clients running Windows connected over a VPN or Direct Connect connection. And you can then talk to a file system, and that file system supports the native Windows file system features such as NTFS file systems and ACLs, shadow copies, and user quotas, amongst other features. And it's accessed over the server message block or SMB protocol. So just as you would mount any other Windows file system, you're talking to it over SMB, it's formatted in NTFS, and it offers you the same features of a native Windows file system. Now, it will automatically talk to a AWS managed Microsoft AD. So you can configure your authentication to happen through Microsoft AD. And when we go through the wizard, I'll show you how that's set up. You can also set up multi-AZ, which means a standby is created in another availability zone. I'm not showing that on the diagram, but that's possible. So that's the FSx for Windows file server. We then have the Amazon FSx for Lustre. Now, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly because I haven't worked with this service before, but this is what it is. Now, the key thing that we'll notice here first off is that we have an S3 bucket. This is key to know for the exam. So you'll need to identify when to use FSx for Windows versus FSx for Lustre. Now, in this case, you can have S3 objects in your bucket, and they can actually be viewed as files in the file system here. And then you can perform your processing on that data and then write the data back to S3. Just like with the FSx for Windows, you can connect on-premises clients over VPNs or Direct Connect connections. And you can also use FSx for Lustre for cloud bursting and data migration. So you might be migrating your on-premise data into the cloud, or you might be bursting into the cloud when you have that requirement to access extra capacity. So that's basically what these two different types of file system are. There's going to be some more information in the exam cram at the end of the section, and there's also lots more information on the training notes and obviously the AWS website as well. So make sure you do know these services, especially if you're going into the SAA C02 exam. Now, what we're going to do now is head over to the console, and we're not going to set up a full implementation like this because it would require quite a lot of resources. And especially with the Lustre, you actually have to provision quite a large chunk of storage, so it could be expensive for you. But I'm going to show you where you create your FSx file systems, and we'll go into the wizard and have a look around and see what the options are. So I'm in the AWS Management Console. Let's go down to Storage and choose FSx. And we can simply choose Create File System. And first off, let's choose Windows File Server. So it says here that the Windows File Server provides a fully managed native Windows file system, so you can easily move your Windows-based applications that require file storage to AWS. And we can see some additional features here that I didn't mention before, like distributed file system. So it supports that as well as the SMB protocol, the NTFS file system type, and Active Directory integration. So let's just choose Next. And we can choose multi-AZ or single AZ. And this will depend on your region. For instance, when I was connected to Sydney earlier, I couldn't choose multi-AZ. And you'll just give it a file system name, so my FSx. And then you can choose your file system size. So let's just choose the minimum size here. And you can then choose where to place your endpoints for your file system. So you can choose your VPC. You can choose your security groups, it's selected one for us, and you can choose one subnet in which the file system's network interface will reside. So just looking back on the diagram, that's why I'm showing the FSx instance as being within an availability zone or within a subnet. If you want to have your file system available in multiple subnets, then that's going to be the multi-AZ feature, which means it's going to be a standby that gets failed over. But otherwise, the endpoint is going to be within a subnet. You then get to choose whether you use a managed Microsoft AD, and that's going to be like we have in the diagram here, or whether you choose a self-managed Microsoft Active Directory. And in that case, you're going to have to just give the details, supply the details for your self-managed Microsoft AD. In this case, you can choose a directory, or you can just choose this to use this wizard to create the directory. And so we actually have to set that up. I'm not going to set that up now. But basically after that, you'll then just complete the wizard and the file system will be created. And then you can take your applications and connect and mount that file system. So we're not going to go into that level of detail in this lab. What I'm going to do now is just back out and we're going to go and have a look in the FSx for Lustre. Let's just choose next. And again, I'm just going to put something in here. And in this case, you can see that the supported sizes are 1,200 gigabytes or gigabytes or 2,400 or increments of 3,600. So, you know, it's got to start pretty big. So we don't really want to provision this, but let's just put something in for now. And again, you can choose your VPC, your security group, and you can choose the subnet in which the network interface will reside. And you can see there's a note here about allowing inbound traffic to TCP port 988. Data is encrypted at rest by default using this XTS AES 256 block cipher. And if we just choose next, it's not going to create anything yet, but it's just going to give us that summary. And you can see you then create the file system. So I wouldn't go ahead and do that because you're going to be basically paying for some storage here that you really don't want to pay for. So we'll just back out of that. But that's the FSx file system. So again, it's in a single subnet. The network interface for the service will actually reside in one subnet. Key exam point here, I think, to remember is whenever you see S3 being mentioned and it looks like an FSx use case, it's going to be FSx for Lustre. And if it's SMB or if it's going to be a Windows-based application, then it's going to push you to FSx for Windows.